Let's now zoom into each individual function to see a little bit more details about it. If you go to the compare, we had the first one, which was a standard versus a paste or file. So what can I do here? First, I can select my version. If I don't have specified or created a client yet, I can select between all the versions. So I could, for example, select an 18 here, and I can see all the country versions which is available from Microsoft on this version. It could be a New Zealand version here, for example. If I select the client, if I list all my clients or create them, it then automatically, as you see here now, pick up the version and country version based on what I have specified on the client. Next, I will provide a short description, and that is mandatory because that will be used as identifier. And on the right side now, you have to decide which kind of compare option you want. And you can see you have the two options. One option, number one, is from the overview. The benefit here is that you don't need to have any license at all, so you can copy anything. And this advantage is you do not have the code, so you can't do, for example, code compare, CU upgrade, and similar features which is related to the code. But how does it work? Well, I open up my designer, I mark some objects like here, I copy, I go back, and I basically paste them in here. And you can now see below, they are now already straight into Object Analyzer. The only thing I have to remember to do here is make sure that my development environment must be set to English. We only support paste in English. The other option I can do is I can select a file instead. The benefit here is, of course, that now I can do all the nice code features. Limitation here will be that, yeah, I can only do it for objects where I have the access right to export in text format. So let me select the file. I select this one. Object Analyzer will now start to read the file and make sure it all is valid and can be read into Object Analyzer. Yep, it's now done. So first it gives us actually a small warning here. You saw in the top that one of my objects is missing the version list. So that's correct. I can see all these objects here. Actually, somebody has forgotten to specify the version list. And then next thing is I have to decide my compare options. In this case, I decide to, in the compare option here, to specify if I want to compare all, or I want to go down and just compare, for example, only date and time, or only want to compare name and version list. That can be very useful, for example, if a set of objects has been added with a country language solution and all the objects has been modified. It means you won't be able to know what is actually the customized objects in the version list. Next option here, so you can see you can compare all. Or we can decide to exclude hotfixes and CU updates, means that if something has been updated from Microsoft, we don't consider that as a change, and that is default. If you have another date format, you can specify that here. Another time format. And you have the options to include system objects if you want that, and the code. In this case, we just want the code. Let's compare and proceed, and now we are notified that you will be charged 50 coins to do that. All right, that's a quick round tour. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you very much.